All right, so today is the 26th of June, and this is the Portland Insight Meditation Community Broadcasting System. My name is Jim Dalton. This is Jim's guest house. It's a remote broadcast that began at the beginning of COVID when I focused a lot on Rumi poems. And so I invite all beings to our guest house and ring a gong. And as the gong, oh, I should ring it again. I always forget to turn on the filter on the sound, so it's just the bell. So we bring our attention to this opportunity to practice, to this moment of life in this body, this moment of belonging to this space. Take a look around you. Notice how many familiar things are in this space where you sit. I've been tracing through the Hua Hu Ching, which is part of the teachings from Lao Tzu. And we don't know if Lao Tzu is a person or a tradition of teachers who followed the same wandering monk who just posted poems on the sides of trees and propped them up against a rock or something like that. You know, there was a whole tradition of wandering monks leaving moments of realization, moments of insight. And so the third translation from the modern approach to the Hua Hu Ching says, those who wish to embody the Tao should embrace all things. So it's it's always funny how things get translated. Our language doesn't really ever let go of the division, of the separation between the person and the Tao, but I'm almost certain that the Chinese did not wish to embody the Tao. It was setting the intention to be aware of embodying the Tao. So the translation we have is a little awkward. It creates a little bit of a separation. And my intention is to allow my distractions of the day to fade away and to remember to embody the Tao. So those who wish to remember to embody the Tao should embrace all things. There's no division. There's no agenda. There's no priority. Embrace all things. To embrace all things means first that one holds no anger or resistance toward any idea or thing, living or dead, formed or formless. So, for instance, if our body is ailing, or if our mood is sad or depressed, or if our level of irritation or aversion is high, we hold no resistance toward any idea or thing. And there might be a remembrance, a memory of past injury that holds remorse if we caused the injury, or if we received the injury, there may be a memory of resentment. And right off the bat, at the beginning of this little poem in Chinese, there's a challenge. Can we face this resistance toward any feeling, any thought, any sensation right here and now? All we have is this moment here and now, in this body sitting here, in this body breathing. And if in this moment there's resistance to any idea or feeling or thought, formed or formless, it could be a mood that you really can't identify. It's just a feeling of, I don't want things to be this way. If you feel yourself moving in that direction, can you just open your heart, open your arms, and kind of hug yourself? It's okay if you're resisting. It's okay if your mood is fatigued or depressed in some way or angry, whatever it is. What is the sensation of breathing? What happens when you allow your body to make this sweet desire for love, for life? I want to be here, embodying the Tao. Acceptance, the poet says, acceptance is the very essence of the Tao. To embrace all things means that one opens oneself to any concept of separation, male and female, self and other, life and death. Division is contrary to embodying the Tao. The nature of the Tao is acceptance. So we sit here listening to the gong slowly fading away, there's silence and there's sounds fading away. In my world, there's sounds just outside my window. There's sounds in the distance. There's sounds as close as my heart and my chest, rising and falling. Sounds. Breathing. body desiring new energy, very quietly drawing in new energy. The body ready to release, letting go, letting be, emptying out, trusting in the empty silence before the next breath in. Everything changing, rising, moving toward fullness, falling, moving toward stillness, rising again. We set our intention to embody this changing flow of cycles of energy and release, rising to greet the next moment, releasing into quiet and silence. And we have this attitude of acceptance, letting the breath release, letting the emptiness be just for a second. There's a turn, there's a reversal between the out-breath and the in-breath. We learn to recognize the ending of a cycle. It's not something we see. It's not visible. It's not something we hear. It's something we don't hear. There's no in-breath. There's no out-breath. Just this silence. And then we recognize the next rising, the cycle moves on with acceptance and patience until we're ready to release. And it's not the ego that's ready to release, it's the body. We bring our attention to the body letting go. And there's a natural rhythm. Calm acceptance and an easy release. calm, easy. Calm acceptance, easy release. Soft belly, easy mind. Acceptance in the mind and the body. Calm face, calm shoulders, calm belly. Easy smile, easy release, loving awareness, in that silent, still point, it's easy to remember that loving awareness underneath, within, without, loving awareness within the body, filling the space in the body. No boundary, no division, loving awareness around the body, behind the body, above and below the body, here, loving awareness filling the space. Trusting the body to breathe in. Trusting the body to release. No holding, no boundary. The air flows in. Releases. Sometimes forgetting, waking up, wandering, recognizing the past, recognizing the future, remembering, loving awareness. Beginning again, intending to breathe, intending to see the breath, to feel the breath, to know the breath. Remembering the calmness here, the ease here, listening to the breath, listening to distant sounds, remembering to remember the silence and the stillness between the in-breath and out-breath. Recognizing resistance, moving into memories of the past, getting lost, getting found. Who is it that finds us? Release into being found. Found by loving awareness. Forgetting antagonism, division, or separation, we enter harmony and oneness of all things. Simple awareness, loving awareness. this moment is like this. There's room for everything in loving awareness. So, shifting from our anchor in the breath and the general feeling of life in the body, we focus in to the center of the chest and the breath moving in and out of the heart. The heart spacious and open, free from resentments in the past as best we can, free from worry in the future as best we can, intending to be here and now in loving awareness. Appreciating the teachings we've received from our guides and mentors, people who've been on the path longer than we, willing to share the insights and the love of the Dharma with us, inspiring us to practice, encouraging us. We focus on one or two teachers with our imagination and just hold them in our hearts, maybe noticing their smile or the twinkle in their eye. Someone it's easy to love, easy to accept, easy to see as a benefactor, someone who is bringing us blessings, either now or in the past, a source of blessings. May they be safe. May they be healthy. May they live in the harmony of the Tao that we started with this evening, embodying the Tao in their every breath, every heartbeat. No separation, no resistance, just harmony and love. There's a yearning for that oneness. We can just let go of that yearning for a second and just let it be there. Yearning is loving awareness. And in that state of harmony and oneness, we can accept ourselves as worthy practitioners, worthy students of the Dharma. Worthy members of the Sangha, worthy of our love. Worthy of our self-respect, worthy of our self-compassion. May we be safe. May we be healthy. May we be free from mental anguish and conflict and separation in ideas and thoughts and feelings. May we remember who we really are. And then we make the intention to share this oneness of feeling, this release from separation embrace our family and friends, the inner circle of people who bring us blessings in our lives and who share in the blessings that we discover and we share. The people it's easy to share with. You picture one or two faces, bring them into our hearts. May they be safe tonight and tomorrow and moving forward. They remember to embody the Tao, the balance with no boundaries, no separation, no conflict, just loving awareness and peace. And then recognizing that all of us in this inner circle, ourselves and our friends and our family, are connected to hundreds and thousands of people who serve in the operation of the flow of blessings that we enjoy as privileged members of our culture and country. We enjoy blessings like clean water, fresh air, no immediate war, no famine. No confusion about leaving one space and trying to cross borders. We just settle back into here and now, freedom from division, no boundaries, no borders. All of us treading the path of the Dharma across the planet. We have immediate experiences with people and places and things that are in relative peace, relative harmony. May that harmony spread over the whole planet. May we share the blessings we have across the planet, across the countryside, the rivers, the lakes, the oceans, the other continents, the planet as a whole. May the planet be safe from imbalance and conflict and turmoil. We hold those wishes in our hearts with sincerity and confidence. Just for one breath, may all beings live in harmony and peace, here and now. May they remember the blessings they have and the blessings they can share. May they remember they belong together with some kind of sangha. Could be a worldwide sangha like Buddhism or Sufism, Jewish traditions, Christian traditions, or it could be just the people in the same tent. Remembering our interconnection and the oneness. oneness of being is at the basis of everything. May all beings share in the merits of this practice. May all beings be safe, be healthy, find harmony in their situation, in their environment. May they taste a little of the real peace that's here and now. And then we'll use the syllable Om to express our good wishes and let the sound of our intentions radiate out to the north and the south and the east and the west, above and below, no boundaries, no borders, one living planet resounding with our chanting. So take a breath. Thank you for joining me this evening. Remember the opportunities we have as part of PIMC. There's morning meditations and Doug Pullen's available on Thursdays. If you're in the Beaverton neighborhood, my front door is open on Thursdays for in-person gatherings. This Saturday I'll be at PIMC and giving a Qigong and meditation retreat from 10 till 4. So even if you can only come for an hour, you can spend a little time with mindful movement and quiet sitting and listening to some, it's not really poetry, it's more poetical prose about the migration of animals and the migration of humans that's going on right now on this planet. It's a big subject. So we're going to use our arms to paint rainbows overhead and be real simple with our movement. And then our reflections are going to be wider ranging. But at any rate, that's Saturday. And then I think it's a quiet week on Sunday in the evening. There will be queer now, but I don't think candles on until the first Sunday in July. But there's all sorts of opportunities to practice. And Sunday at 10 o'clock, we have a regular session that is going to be including twice a month opportunity for young people to practice the Dharma. So we have a teacher and several volunteers lined up with a curriculum from now until September and October, and we'll reevaluate and see how it's working with which ages and how many volunteers we have. We may expand it, but right now I think it's just ages 5 to 12, young people 5 to 12. So those are some of the things going on at PIMC. I'll sign off on Facebook and we'll see you next time. Be well.